this is one very simple, interesting toy where there is one doll, and this doll, if I try to balance on my fingertip, it cannot balance because it has the center of mass here and the support is here. If it is supported below center of mass, then it will have tendency to fall down. But if I give this doll the two hands and give the weight in each hand, we can make the doll stable on my fingertip. So this is stable. It has got equilibrium, balancing capacity. Now why it is able to balance? Because the two masses on two sides, they are pulled down by the earth, that is gravity. And the doll has stability because of symmetry here. The symmetry is very important. Now if we make this doll to tilt on one side and leave it, what will happen? Normally people think that the doll will fall down, but it is wrong idea. The doll doesn't fall, it suddenly comes up, it rises. Now question is, why the doll rises? We'll find out reason behind it. The reason is very simple. This mass and this mass, three masses are connected by the two rods. Now when I keep it on finger, it is stable because the combined center of mass of three masses, combined center of mass of three bodies, is somewhere here. When center of mass is here, now one may ask question, how you know it is here? There is a very simple trick. You can find where is center of mass. Suppose you hang a thread and drop the plumb line, you'll get one. Now if you drop the plumb line, you'll get another one. If you drop the plumb line, you'll get another one. And these three lines are intersecting at one point, and that point is like centroid of a triangle. And centroid of a triangle, that point is called as center of mass. This center of mass is very important because of course I am assuming that M1, M2, M3 are equal masses, and centroid is the center of mass. And the rule says that if the center of mass is below the point of suspension, pivoting, then the body can have equilibrium. Even I can keep this on a tip of a stick and I can say that the rod, the doll is stable, and even if I give some rotational motion, it goes round, but still it doesn't fall. It doesn't fall because it is pivoted on a position and center of mass is below, so it will have stability. If it is other way around, center of mass is above and pivot is below, it will fall down. That is very simple, common sense. Now, the same thing we can do with another doll, and this was made for blind students. For blind students, this is also possible by touch. They can understand this experiment by touching all the parts and by sensing on the finger. They can feel center of mass, they can feel symmetry, they can feel the weight, balancing. But if you ask a blind student, have you seen the circus? In circus, there is one girl riding on a monocycle, and that monocycle goes over the rope hang by two poles. It is very difficult for a blind student to imagine also, because he has no eyesight. But we have made a toy which could explain the blind students what happens in circus. Here, very simple teaching aid for blind students is, this is a doll with monocycle, single pulley, and we are having special attachment here so that we can have the two hands, and the girl has taken two weights in the hands. Two weights are a heavy bar on both sides for symmetry. We have a rope tied with the help of two poles, and it should be tied sloping down. And if I leave this on the rope, you can see that it goes straight and it doesn't fall. It goes balancing because you can raise the height, yes, okay. So this is possible because center of mass is below. You can see center of mass is here. Heavy weights are there, so center of mass will come down. And if it is below the point of pivoting, it will have automatic stability. Now question is how blind students can understand this. What they do, what I tell them to do is, you hold the rope tight and make it proper. And when I leave this, tell the student to touch the rope. When he will touch the rope, he will find that rope is having vibrations. And the vibrations in the rope indicate that something is rolling over this rope. And by that way, they can visualize, they can imagine what is happening with the rope. Something is rolling over the rope. And that day, when blind student said that, yes, today I have seen the circus, it was my great joy. Thank you.